It is said that precaution is better than cure. It means it is better to stop something bad from happening than to deal with it after it has happened. With this note, let's begin with the topic safety first. To be safe in all situations is very important. Safety means to take precaution to save ourselves from any injury or loss. Safety is protecting oneself from any harm. The rules we follow to keep ourselves safe are called as safety rules. We must follow these rules at home as well as outside the home. Here are some of the important safety rules one should follow. Safety rules to be followed at home. Keep the things in the right place. Never play with a matchbox. It is dangerous. Never play with sharp objects like blades, knives and scissors. Take the help of an adult when you need to use them. Never touch electric points and switches with wet hands. You might get an electric shock. We should not touch a hot iron. It can burn you. Never light a gas stove on your own. We should not lean from a terrace or from a balcony. Always see the visitor through the peephole. Open the doors only to people you know. Do not let strangers enter your house. Never run down the stairs or slide down the banister of your stairs. You may twist your foot or fracture your bones. Be careful while using lifts or elevators. Never put your hand in between the doors of a lift to reopen it. We can try to avoid common injuries by following these safety rules at home. Safety rules in the school. School is a place to learn and explore many new things, but by being careful, we may avoid many uncertainties. Let us see how we can be safe and secure in the school by following some simple steps. Do not climb on the benches and play. Do not push each other. Always move in a queue in corridors. Never bring any sharp object to the school which might hurt others. We must not fight with others or hurt each other. We should always follow the school rules. After knowing the safety rules to be followed in the school, let us know some of the safety rules to be followed while traveling in the bus. We need to be careful while getting in and out of the school bus. Injuries can happen if we are careless and hasty. We should keep ourselves safe by sitting at one place when the bus is moving and not to try to peep out of the moving school bus. Some more rules to remember and follow are: always stand in a queue while waiting for a bus. Do not push others while getting on or off a bus. Never put your head or hand out of a moving vehicle. Do not open the door of a moving vehicle. Do not eat or drink in a moving bus. Let's know some of the safety rules to be followed while playing. Do not play on the road. We should follow certain safety measures while playing, like to play in an open area. It may be a park or a ground. Do not fly kites on an open terrace. Do not go for a swim alone in deep water. Always remember to do swimming in presence of an adult or a supervisor. Avoid fighting with anyone. To keep yourself safe while you are out walking, remember these rules. If there is no sidewalk where you are walking, walk on the side of the road where you will be facing oncoming traffic. Follow the traffic rule put by the government. Few important measures to follow while walking on the road are: always walk on the footpath. Cross the road at the zebra crossing. Look at the traffic signals. We should always see the traffic light. Red, green, and yellow are the colors we must follow. Red says stop, green says go, and yellow says wait. Never cross a railway line. Use bridge or a subway for the same. Do not tease or harm stray dogs and cows. We have learned about safety in different situations, but if any accident occurs unknowingly, what can be done so that the patient gets first-hand treatment before taking him or her to the nearby hospital? So the immediate treatment given to the patient at the time of emergency is called as first aid. First aid is the help given immediately when a person falls ill, is injured, or meets with an accident. After giving first aid, we must quickly take the injured person to the doctor or call an ambulance. First aid can prevent the problem from becoming serious. So we must have a first aid box at home and carry it with us whenever we go out for a picnic or tour. So it's very important to have a first aid box to provide the first-hand treatment to the person who is in need. It's important to have a first aid box at your home and in the vehicles, as it provides help during the various emergency situations. Now, when we have learned to take care of ourselves, we must also take care that our actions do not harm others. We should not push or hurt others. When somebody around us is hurt, we should immediately tell an adult. We should not hide our injuries from our parents or adults. Injuries such as dog bites, burns, etc. will only get worse if not treated immediately. We should never get close to strangers or eat anything they give. We should tell our parents or a teacher if a stranger approaches. The person whom we have never seen or know are known as stranger, who may prove to be dangerous for us. Let us all know some of the safety rules one should follow in their regular life. Know your parents' full name, contact number, and home address. Am I talking to the person whom you have never seen? Try to wear safety gears appropriate for the activity you do. If in case you get lost, do not get panic. Learn how to handle this situation. Have a habit to wash your hands with a soap or a liquid to avoid spreading of germs. Let us all follow all safety measures to have a happy and safe future.